next generation of leaders in this room today here. That's the students in the different universities and the different colleges. And really, I'm so happy because this is actually the next generation of young, the next generation of leaders in tech. And even before I just take us through what this challenge is all about, a lot of the previous speakers have actually talked about the power of GIS. And I just want to quote one of the main things that Jack usually says. So Jack is the president of ISRI, and Jack the German says that the application of GIS is limited only by the imagination of those who apply it. So there are actually unlimited areas of applying GIS. So it can only be limited by your imagination. And even as we launch this challenge today, I'm hoping that we'll actually be very innovative, very creative, and go all out to actually have very innovative solutions for our world. So as already mentioned, this is the first challenge. And ISRI South Africa is actually pleased to launch the first challenge of, the first challenge that we are calling MAP Challenge. And this first challenge is actually focused on the SDGs. So this first challenge is focused on the Sustainable Development Goals. So what we want you to do is actually demonstrate how you can be able to use the power of GIS to be able to solve some of the problems and actually focus on sustainable development around the SDG goals. I know Nahashan has already mentioned and has already taken us through the SDGs. So this is what this challenge will actually be focused on. We'll be sharing this site on the chat and actually having it on our platforms right after this launch. So this first challenge is on the SDGs. We'll be having a series of challenges. So this is just the first one in a series of many that we'll be having. And then important to note are the key dates. So we'll officially launch this challenge today. Then we'll be having a series of technical workshops. So the technical workshops will basically help you better understand how to use the ArcGIS technology, the tools that we have for you to be able to create very impactful solutions. And then the other thing that I need to mention is that whatever you have done should be submitted by the 5th of November for our judges, for our panel of judges to be able to actually determine the winners. And the winners will be announced on November 17th, that's on GIS Day. So during the GIS Day also, you'll have an opportunity, the winners will have an opportunity to present what they've been working on and the best solutions that you've been working on around the SDGs. So that's what this particular MAP challenge is all about. And then to also help you as you do this particular challenge, we have a number of resources on our hub sites. These will also be shared on our platforms that you can be able to make use of. So we have a number of resources, right, from how to create a story map. Remember that the final product of the solution that we have developed around the SDGs has to be presented in a story map. So you'll actually be able to see some of the resources on how to create your first story map, tips on how to give very interesting stories. You'll be able to make use of these resources. And then you'll also have a lot of the other resources and tools that we have within the platform, such as the ArcGIS platform. For those of us who are interested in development, coding, this is also a very good tool to use. And then we'll also have more information on the SDGs. Remember, this challenge is focused on the Sustainable Development Goals. So we have a lot of information on the Sustainable Development Goals and how to tell your story using the tools that you have within the platform. So those are some of the resources that you will be using. We'll be sharing this link and you can be able to interact and actually see a lot of the things. So I know the most important thing that all of you want to actually hear is, so how do we get registered? How do you get to register to be part of this challenge? So we also have the page, the registration page. So here we have a registration link. And even before we get to the registration link, we have the terms and conditions for you to be able to participate in this particular MAP challenge or competition. So you need to read through the terms and conditions. And then once you've read through the terms and conditions, you can now come to the registration page. So you register here. There will be a form that has various, that will capture various details. Part of the details, we want to ensure that the people actually participating in this challenge are university students. We'll also be interested in knowing which university you are from and the location and all that, and the country. Again, this competition is actually open for students in the Eastern African region. That's Kenya, Uganda, Tanzania, Ethiopia, Djibouti and Eritrea. So if you're a student at any level, undergraduate, postgraduate, if you're at college, and you want to be part of this challenge is actually open for all students in all our countries within Eastern Africa. So you'll be able to register to enter this competition, and then we'll be able to give you feedback whether your idea has actually is good enough for you to proceed into the competition. So that's what you need to know about this particular competition. And then again, for the rules, we're looking at originality. Please ensure that the work that you'll be presenting in this competition is actually your original work. And we want to see how creative you can actually get. We want to get to see how creative you can get using GIS to actually solve some of the world's challenges. And for this particular challenge, we are focused on the SDGs. So our panel of judges will be able to review all the submissions that will have been done, and we'll be able to announce the winners during the GIS day. So we're actually looking forward to your very innovative solutions around the SDGs. And one of the quotes that I really love is that you either innovate or die. So we are really looking forward to those very innovative solutions and ideas on the 17th of November when we'll be announcing the winners. So so that's what you need to know about the competition or the challenge. So I'll hand it over back to Biko for us to officially launch this.
Yeah, thanks, Evelyn. Ladies and gentlemen, those the rules and the regulations of what is going to be an exciting challenge ahead. I hope you guys are excited. At this point, I'd ask you guys to turn on your videos, and we are about to count down. It's now 1:29. We've perfectly timed it because now is the time where we need to launch this event. I know.